There's a saying in County Clare that you have to eat a bag of salt before you know a Kerry man. But hey, that mightn't be true at all. It would be more near the mark if you said you have to eat a lorry load of salt. Because they're the most cute crowd you'll meet in all of Ireland. And there's none of them that was more cute than Daniel O'Connell. In terms of the law, you could not get the better of him. No. In Kerry, in that time, the people were poor. And there was a farmer, a small farmer indeed, he was living not so many miles from Tralee. And he had 6 cattle to sell, and in those days you had to sell cattle to pay the rent. And he said he'd take them into the fair in Tralee, which he did. And he was walking in the road, and about 2 miles from the town, he had to pass this shop. And the man in charge of the shop, oh, he was a gobby merchant, a cute buyer. He was always watching the road for the opportunity coming. And he saw the man with the cattle, and he says, "Ha ha. A man from the mountain, I might be able to make a killing here." Out in the road he went, stood in front of the man and says, "Hi, hi, tell me this, how much would you take for the good and the bad of those cattle?" And poor farmer, of course, thought that he was talking about the best and the worst of them. "Oh, God," says he, thinking to himself, "I suppose £10 would be a fair price," and it was a very fair price. "Fine, fine," says the shopkeeper, went in, put his hand into the till and brought out £10. There you are, says he, clapping it into his hand. And of course the farmer was delighted, because he never expected to sell his cattle altogether. And with that he says, "Here, take your cattle there, good man, I'm delighted to meet you." And what do you think the shopkeeper did? Only took out a piece of raddle or something like that out of his pocket and marked the 6 cattle with it. Wait a minute, says the farmer. "I only sold you 2 of the cattle." "You're wrong," said the shopkeeper. "You sold me the best and the worst of them, the whole lot together." "No, you're a thief and a robber and a scoundrel," said the farmer. "Hiya, you can take me to court if you like." "The law will support me," says the shopkeeper. And the farmer knew he was bait. He wasn't an educated man. He had to go home with the price of 2 cattle only for the price of 6. He told his wife about it. "What'll we do, says he, we'll starve." And she says, "Hiya, 'twas a dirty trick to play on you, but there's only one man to help you now. Go to Daniel O'Connell and go there this day." And he did. Walked all the way to Carsaivean and down beyond it until he came to Derry Nan. And Dan was at home, lucky enough. And when the man told Dan the story, Dan says, "Hi, you have no business coming to me. I can do nothing for you. He has you bait hands down." "Ah, but Mr. O'Connell," says the farmer, "you know he wronged me. He stole my property. What'll I do?" And Dan had pity on him, and he thought, and he says, "Tell me," says he, "the man that bought them cattle from you, does he sell tobacco?" "He does, of course, he does." And it was all chewing tobacco in those times. You could buy it by the foot. "Uh-huh. Would he make any noise," says Dan, "if you went in and asked him for a couple of yards of it?" "He wouldn't indeed," says the man. "If you had the money, he'd sell his own mother." "Well, hi," says Dan, "I have to ask you now, and it mightn't suit you. What would you say about losing the tops of your ears?" Your man looked at him. Well, says he, "if it helped me to get my own back on that blackguard, I'd do anything." "All right," says Dan. "Have you relatives in England?" "Oh, isn't there 3 generations of us over there working for our living?" "Good," says Dan, and with that he took his razor, cut the tips off of your man's ears, and he put them into a little box. "Give me the address of your relatives in England, and I'll post these ears over to the relative, and we'll see." "But how will that help me?" says the farmer. "Listen, we'll go back to that shop tomorrow," says Dan, "and I'll go in and I'll buy something small like matches. And after me, you go in and you'll ask that shopkeeper from the tops of your toes to the tops of your ears worth of tobacco, and pay him the money down when he gives it to you. But when he gives it to you, take off your hat and say, 'Hi, hi, you didn't give me all that I paid for.' And he'll say, the shopkeeper will say, 'Of course I did. What are you talking about?' And then you'll tell him, 'Hiya, the tops of my ears are over in England.' And he'll cuss and swear, and he'll deny everything. But, hiya, I'll be there to witness the whole thing." So, the following day, they did go back to the shop. And Dan went in, got his matches, something small, and faded into the background. And it wasn't a very easy thing for him to do, because he was a big man, but he was there, and that was the important thing. And the farmer, he went over and he asked for, "Sir, will you give me from the tops of my toes to the tops of my ears worth of tobacco?" The fellow inside the counter never recognised him, only sized him up and down and says, about 5'4", I'd say, of tobacco. And he cut it, and the farmer paid him for it, and the minute the money was took, the farmer took off his hat and says, Hi, wait a minute, sir. You didn't give me all I paid for. What do you mean, said the shopkeeper? You got every inch of it. I didn't. I asked you from the tops of my toes to the tops of my ears of tobacco, and you didn't give it to me because the tops of my ears are over in England. You have a lot of tobacco to give me yet. Well, the shopkeeper, he cursed and he swore, and he went blue in the face nearly, but the man says to him, look, it's the truth. And at that, Daniel O'Connell came up and... I'm a witness to everything, and what he's saying is true, because I sent his ears over to England myself yesterday. Well, the shopkeeper was caught, and he knew it, because if he went to any court of law in the country, they'd hold against him. And Dan says, Hiya, you better settle up with this man here. How much will you settle for? £300, says the farmer, and it was a fortune in those days. He cursed a bit more, the shopkeeper, at that, but in the end he had to pay up. And he called them all kinds of thieves and villains and vagabonds. But sure, all they said to him was, look, 'twas no worse than you did to this poor man here. That was Dan's last word in it. The man got his money, they went out, and I suppose Dan O'Connell got his fee out of it. He wasn't the poorer for it anyway.